Does your organization have a single sign-on solution for accessing applications within your domain? Have you considered how you might implement multi-domain SSO as you move from on-premise to the cloud? Let's take a look at the scenario where a user requires access to three applications, two residing in the home domain, and the third residing in the cloud in an external domain. Traditional SSO solutions generally use cookies to maintain authentication state for a user session. This means that the user doesn't need to re-authenticate each time they access a protected resource within that domain. The user can access applications A and B with a single login session as they reside in the home domain. While browser cookies can be transmitted within a domain, they can't be transmitted between DNS domains. This means the authentication state is not available to other domains. The user can't use the current SSO solution to access application C because it resides in the external domain. Because of this restriction, traditional multi-domain SSO solutions have implemented proprietary mechanisms to maintain and pass authentication state between domains. This requires that the SSO solution in each domain be from the same vendor. But what happens if you want to implement multi-domain SSO where each domain uses SSO from different vendors? Security Assertion Markup Language, or SAML, is a framework for describing and exchanging security between online business partners, which enables cross-platform authentication between web applications or web services. At a high level, SAML enables security information to be expressed in the form of SAML assertions that applications working across security domain boundaries can trust. So who are the participants involved in the SAML standard? A subject or principal is an entity which is authenticated within a specific security domain about which something is being asserted. A subject is a human user, but can also be another type of entity, for example, a company or a computer. A SAML asserting party or SAML authority is a system entity that makes SAML assertions. A SAML relying party is a system entity that uses assertions that it's received. Reliance on information contained in an assertion is based on a trust relationship between the asserting and relying parties. A SAML role defines the SAML services and protocols used by a system entity for a specific use case. For example, the web single sign-on user case has the roles identity provider and service provider. So what is a SAML assertion? A SAML assertion is a package of information that supplies one or more statements made by a SAML authority. The type of information supplied falls under three broad categories. First, an assertion may contain authentication statements. These contain details about when and how a subject was authenticated. For example, the user was authenticated based on an email address and password. Attribute statements provide specific information about the subject. For example, Clarence Saladna has gold card status or is a member of the admins group. Finally, authorization statements may be supplied identifying what the subject is entitled to do. Other SAML concepts include SAML bindings, SAML metadata, and SAML profiles. SAML bindings define how lower-level communication and messaging protocols, for example, HTTP and SOAP, are used to transport SAML protocol messages between participants. SAML metadata defines a way to express and share configuration information between SAML parties. SAML metadata uses XML documents and is defined by its own XML schema. SAML profiles are a combination of assertions, protocols, and bindings that are required to meet a particular business use case. For example, the web browser SSO profile and the identity federation profile. The web browser single sign-on profile is the most common way SAML is used. This profile enables multi-domain SSO to be implemented in a standard way. For example, let's take a scenario where we have an identity provider, my corporation, and a service provider, Book My Flight. The user has an identity in the My Corporation domain, but wants to be able to authenticate to the Book My Flight domain in order to book a flight. The user makes a request to a protected resource on the Book My Flight site. The user isn't known to the site, but it is a service provider configured with My Corporation as an identity provider. Book My Flight redirects the user request to My Corporation for authentication. The user is authenticated by the identity provider using whatever authentication mechanism is configured. A SAML assertion is generated, providing details of the authentication together with any other information required by the SAML agreement between the two parties. The SAML assertion is then passed back to the Book My Flight site, which reads the information and, based on that, allows or denies access. In this way, the user is able to access a protected resource on the service provider without having to re-authenticate locally at the service provider. We have reviewed the basic concepts and flows associated with SAML, including service providers, identity providers, SAML assertions, SAML bindings, SAML metadata, and SAML profiles. In the next video in this series, we'll examine SAML flows in detail and see how SAML assertions and user information are exchanged. Thank you for watching.